Hi, John here. Today, Tuesday, the 8th of November 2016, it's 7:12 a.m. in Auckland, New Zealand, Otahu. Bringing the latest on our observations of the elections in the United States. It looks certainly like Trump is having big crowds and more favour for being the President of the United States. Clean the swamp out of rats. So I've made three videos yesterday and I'm going to make another one today on more progress on our Navy situation with the 22 countries bringing their Navy ships here, including the USS Samson ship and their attendance here at the celebrations of 75 years in the New Zealand Navy. So the captain of that ship is Tim Lebens, and I have sent a warning to him and the US federal state government Secretary of Defense, Ash Carr, that it is forbidden for America, United States, federal state government to use martial law here or TPPA laws here to command over this Admiralty flag of King William the Fourth and our Moai Native chiefs, Whakameninga, and this flag, straight to Britain, Navy, which appears to be not coming. The British Navy military is not attending the 75 years of celebration in Auckland, New Zealand. I'm quite surprised that they have allowed this country and its thugs, pirates in Australia, New South Wales, New Zealand Company, to not invite them here as part of the celebrations of 75 years of Navy in New Zealand, Australia, and America. You see, they've separated themselves from Britain. And I'm saying this, John Key, Prime Minister of New Zealand, you're forbidden from making agreements with the United States and the Queen going through the back door instead of coming straight through the front door to us, the landowners here, the landlords, and the private contract business partners to the British Navy and military and Westminster government. You wouldn't have been on these lands, John Key, if it wasn't for them and their flag. You have no substance title here on these lands. And when we go into the Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, on Waitangi Day, New Zealand Day, we'll be issuing notice to sever your occupation land titles at Korerareka, Russell, and the rest of this country. From that first title, from Britain, we'll seize all your titles, New South Wales, government, and prison convicts here running this New Zealand government in Wellington. It was Gareth Morgan, business philanthropist, that said, put a bomb under the beehive and blow it up. The same with White House, put a bomb underneath and flatten it and start again with Trump as its new president. Get rid of all that dirty stuff that's in there from the Queen. The Queen, in this case, is the biggest culprit out of all the ISIS and all the carnage and corruption and fraud going on in the world through America as her cash cow over the American people voting now to get her out, to get Clinton out and Obama out. The swamp rats and drain the swamp. That's what Trump is saying, drain the swamp. Here in New Zealand too, drain the swamp, and Australia, and Canada, and all the Commonwealth countries, that has the Queen's head on it. We're going to England to sack her. Matt Taylor, ex-military police. He's our leader there of the Moai King William Party, political party, when I get there, to formulate a dual government contract, private contract through this flag of King William IV and our reigning monarch, King of Britain, UK, Hanover, Aotea, New Zealand, Pacific Islands, and the world for their banner, the New World Order, here. King Ernest Augustus V and his son, Prince Regent Ernest Augustus. He's 38 and King Ernest Augustus V is 68. Okay, same year as me, 67, 1 year less. Okay, so now I'm appealing to the people in the world watching these videos I'm putting on now. They're crucial. They're decision makers with the Admiralty private contract that's ruining the whole world with, because the Queen has given it to the Pope, has given it to the Rothschilds family, has given it to Obama administration and the Clinton Foundation and Soros and all those people, Bill Gates and all those people, the UN, she's given it to the IMF, she's given it to the Pope and the Vatican Church, Church of England, and she's given it to all the thugs who are operating piracy. This is a pirate's flag. It is a declaration of war flag. When it goes up like this, it means a state of emergency occurs here. So we put a state of emergency right over the world with this flag straight to Britain, who are obligated to adhere to our wishes of the native on behalf of all the native indigenous countries in the world. This flag is the answer to get rid of the corporate thugs, pirates. Okay? We're starting that process right here in New Zealand in Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court. Our native chiefs will be in there and the native judge. I'm the sheriff, the native sheriff and native land commissioner responsible for the Manukau land titles that were put together in Britain under the Manukau Land Company registered in Scotland, Glasgow, that established all these titles here and right through the world, the native titles, with Tera Waikato Wharaherehere, Manukau, in Cambridge University and Cambridge here in the Waikato district, his pa site at Mangatauturi Mountain. Okay, so I'm just saying this title here, the 8-point star and King William the Fourth, King William the Third, St. Patrick's Order and his crown and his horse and his ship of Admiralty here seals the deal of private contract by default on Queen Elizabeth II and Queen Victoria's trust, defaults back to King William the Third and King William the Fourth and King Ernest Augustus V, reigning monarch 2016. Okay, we're nominating him into Parliament on the throne, King Ernest Augustus V, as of now. That's my next setup with the chiefs, is to nominate him into the throne to take the Queen's vacated position. She's jumped overboard. Under Admiralty, she's abandoned ship. You hear that? Queen Elizabeth II has abandoned ship and gone into the EU Parliament. She might be physically in London, but she's ready to escape if someone tries to get her. If you don't get her, Moai will. Moai will get her. Okay, so that's where we're starting from, her fraud corrupted business inside the Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court and John Key. And all the previous Governor Generals are liable now. £1 trillion each on their heads, including Jerry Mataparai, who is the ambassador to New Zealand in London, he gets more than that on his head, £1 trillion. He's got a bounty on his head the same as the Queen and every other Governor General right back. We're backdating the levy debtor bill against the government's agents of the Crown Corporation Queen right back to 1830, the 1837 period of our flag, jurisdiction of Admiralty, private law. Financial martial law is now on you, John Key. And that ship coming here, if you make agreements with the TPPA and with martial law, US martial law, under vice admiralty of a queen who's not there, against the King William the Fourth and King Ernest Augustus bloodlines, you're in trouble. You're in trouble. I'm making this video, our proof of claim, evidence to support any arrests of you and the rest of your cabal, Illuminati, thug, pirates. That's what I'm calling you on this video. Okay, now I'm going to ring our chief in Whakatohe, Jim Wikotu. I've got to tell him to check his email. I'll try and get a hold of King Totoro too. Those two chiefs. He'll ring back. I'll let him ring back, but I'll keep talking about what's happening today. I've sent a notice off to Louise Ixley, the British High Commissioner Assistant in Wellington, New Zealand, forewarning her of what is happening with the United States federal state government, Obama administration, Clinton Foundation, FBI, and the fraud and corruption going on in the elections. The new president. Here he is. Hello, Jim. Jim, check your email today. I've sent the 11 pages of the document I've stuck out that's got the quarter article with you there. I've cut it up. I've cut the video up and stuck it in the notice against John Key and the U.S. ship, the Samson, U.S. Samson ship coming. You know there's no British ship coming? It makes you wonder why they've left the British ship out, British Navy out. They've only got 22 countries of their own organization. They're making this TPPA over here with the Waitangi Marae as their authority to the Admiralty through John Key to enforce the martial law here right through all the native countries. It's all done here. So this has got it, I've written it all up there, and it's got you there too because you're a key factor in the whole thing, the whole flag issue. There's nobody else that can do what you're assigned to do when we go up on Waitangi. I'll put all the documents together, seizing the land, and the British have to seize it on your behalf and of the chief's behalf, okay? And I'll, between you and I, will arrange the native judges. You've got Manahi there, and there's another one. I think Willie's got another fella up in Hokianga, or you probably know somebody anyway, someone with an original surname. It can't be an English name. Or a bodgy Maori name. That's what I'm separating that out in this side of this Moai statue, East Island title to the lands. That's the memorial that we use. apart from the Maori ones, but the Maori ones are being corrupted, and that's where it's all caught up. That's the, what happens on the Waitangi Marae has got nothing to do on the Te Tiki Marae side of those contracts. They're two separate contracts. The Queen's one is in the Te Tiki, and the King's one is on the other side. That's the one they're playing around with, Jim. And that's why all those navies are coming here, because they've got those navies for themselves, for their own private things, all right? So I really have to find somebody to talk to up in Hokkien or Ngāpu anyway. You'll probably find someone with a proper surname. You see, my name goes with the history of the Moai. Your name goes with the history of the land of the old names, right? I'm speaking for Mohi Manukau and Tera Waikato, Wharaherehere. That title, that's the one they put together in 1820 in England. Right? That's the native title they put there. No one's seen it because I've got it all here from Mohi. He wouldn't tell anybody. So I'm using that for the commercial side, right? The money side, the checkbook is there. The checkbook is there, and where you come with the flag, that's the authority, right? That's the authority to the native. Straight to England. And I'll deal with the bank this way, and we stick it to them with the pound note inside that marae. That's what we're setting up here. But it's gone around the world now on video. I've got videos there. You can see a video of me talking about the Secretary of Defense in America, Ash Carter. Okay, I've got a letter gone to him and to the British High Commission here, warning them of who we are as the native title holder with that flag. The flag is going to bust them all, right? The flag itself will bust them, because that's the only king's flag in the world with Admiralty private contract. It's a bank flag. That's the part that Mary doesn't understand. It converts anything to cash as a king's prize positions. So that's, it's all there now. You just read those documents. It's got you there all over it, and a little bit of Kingi, but I have to be very careful with Kingi, because he's on both sides, and he is really an Edwards, right? His name is not Taurua, it's Edwards, but he comes under King Edward line with Queen Victoria, so that's where the Queen Victoria Trust is, him, right? So I go after them, put him to claim the trust, that's all he's there for. And you know, they haven't got a real chief there. The Hey Hey's, Tracy was telling me, is not a real name either. So you have to watch the names. And I've been researching all the names. Even Ohepa, Epiha, he's an Epping from New South Wales and Epping in Sussex, England. That's his real name, not Epiha. You won't find Epiha anywhere in the history of where it came from. They'll only say he comes out of the sea. So I'm being blunt with them, because it's not time to waste time with people who stand on their feet and talk about themselves and something else when they can't talk about their name, right? If someone said to me, where the Wanoa's come, I'll say the Wanoa history all the way back to East Island and Rangatira Island. So you're the same there with the Waka, right? So that's how it works. But that's all I've been doing for now. Anything else? The standing orders, that comes from Mapidia had those. I just have to go back through my notes, because I got all his stuff here. I know it back to front. But the standing orders comes from the... Eh? Yeah, he put the standing... That comes from Westminster. Everything on Westminster I'm doing myself. I'm going to Westminster. Right, the standing orders, I'll explain everything on videos, it's better. So when you I'll write that one down, and I'll explain what it is and what it applies to us from Westminster, that's the same with the flag, the standing orders coming from the flag and Busby and all of that lot. So I'll explain in videos. It's quicker than standing in a marae. I'll get nowhere. And the whole world is watching us now, because this is where the key is to unlock the whole thing. The standing orders just means that it's like the Parliament makes an order, and that's the law as far as we're concerned. The standing orders come. Yeah, that's when we walked across the bridge. I don't know if you did. The time when the police were on the other side, and he got on the wheelchair and went on the bridge and told him to get out of the way. There. That's the time, and we went straight to the flag, and the Maori party went straight up to the Marae. They went around the back. They went around the back, and I said, "Huh, where they go?" And they were standing in the front, trying to lead the place, right? And we were in a tent. We had 80 incorporations. I was in the Horoita one. We got 7 of ours still there now. I'm in the Potiki Rua Ki Waiapu area, from Cape Runaway to Rangitukia. East Cape, all that area, and back of the Raukumanas, that the Potikiru area, Potaka, through there. What? Well, that's ongoing Crown stuff, but it's mixed up with all those other tribes. I'm going under. Like Uetaha, is the chief of all that Potikirua area, and so you've got Uepoatu, that's Tunakura jumping right over Uetaha land, and all the, you got them all jumping all over it, but that chief will wipe them out, right? The Uetaha, the name Uetaha, and Uepoatu to Hikurangi. Those are the original names of the chiefs then, and Tuwhakairua Iriora come in the middle of it, right? He's come later, and that's part of our history, but it's clouded over, with the crowns clouded it over, the Uetaha one. It's been lost. So, Yeah, that's right. That's where he's buried, I think. That's where he did his training. He was born there. Yeah, he was born there, trained there, but he's buried at the. They don't know where his grave is at Te Araroa. On the hill on the other side of the Awatera River. They don't know. When that place built, burnt down, the Hinirupi and Marae burnt down, that's not the right name. It burnt down, and they were blaming Tuwhakairua up the hill. Why it burnt down. I just forget what the name of that marae is. Even like the Marangaro marae, they changed to Aotele marae. That's my own marae. They changed. It used to be Marangaro marae for all the Marangaro lands. Yeah, they've changed everything, and I'm going back. I'm having them up for changing it, changing all the history titles. And yeah, they changed the names. Yeah. And even the one at Te Araroa, they changed the name of to Hinirupe on the woman's side, not the man's side. You see, and they put my great grandfather Mataru Wano in the kitchen and took it out of the marae and changed the whole bloody place and put Te Aotahi there. The Brookings, who are Americans, they did that. Brookings are Americans, and like the Harawiras are Americans, you see. And the Harawiras are Hatfields. See, they're not the real name. The name is not real. And that's why you got to watch. You got to watch all those names. And I've got all their names. I've got all the names to what they changed to. You got to watch who's talking on their feet. The same. Yeah, it's in your email. You can see the videos. I'm explaining everything, every single thing, so that by the time we go to Waitangi, we'll have the order to sever the Navy's contract, the occupation land title at Korarareka. Once you get rid of that one, the whole lot will fall over. Because that's the very first British title. The other one's in New South Wales. See, the British confiscated all the lands from New South Wales in 1868. And then they reissued the titles. These are the ones, the Manukau titles came and took the whole lot out. Right? The Manukau Land Company in Scotland came and seized them all. So we're going to seize them all and do it again. That's the 18th. Yeah, for now, but I'm going to be talking about it, but I think all those people watching the videos I'm sticking out now, lots of videos of me talking about things right to the point of the Crown and the Navy can't do anything about it. So by the time we go to Waitangi Day on the 6th of February, into that marae, we'll be in there with them and then give it to them in there, because they'll have to come, and then you and Bruce can do your thing outside, and it'll be official then. We'll have them trapped inside that marae and have the two native judges and me, the sheriff, to hand the bill over, okay? So that's how we do it. Yeah? Now, don't worry too much about it, because they've got no authority. That's only up the road. That's not off the shore and gone overseas. That'll only happen here, because they've got their own things. They're quite welcome to their things until you stand in court with your documents, or in that marae up in Waitangi. That's running the whole world, that marae, believe it or not. Yeah, it's operating all the native countries in the world through that marae. when that US ship gets here, he's got a martial law on the captain. The captain will do the same thing as the captain on Kororareka in the first place, say the land belongs to the queen or the king, right? So all I had to say in English, takes me 5 minutes, is that the land belongs to the chief, not the queen or the king. And then you fellas take over after that. That's all I had to say, really. And then hand in the bill. The debtor notice, but all those other ones, that lady there with the moko, as well for the mokopuna, they've already gone down to Parliament and got shoved out. They've already gone to England and got shoved out. Soon the Cora's been to the United Nations and got shoved out, because she's not a chief. That's why they're not chiefs. It was the chiefs under the Portugal tree that was talking about getting the king, not a woman. And so that's where it starts and ends, all right? So you got the right name to the land to talk on your feet. And you'll see that those fellows are lost in Waitangi when they get on their feet and talk, because they're mixed up with their surnames are in the wrong place, and they're talking to someone who was here before they came. It's not their fault. It's not their fault. It's their ancestors' fault for telling them different stories. like they're talking over the top of an older history, because they're colonized and they're only talking about the land and not what the flag is, the money, right? They use spirit and everything else to go around. The problem itself is the flag and the money that's being made while they're talking. There's money being made by the navies, and when those navies come here, they form the basis of their conglomerate. A new one. They're reviewing the Navy right through the world on that day, and Britain is not there. They won't come because the government there says no, they're not going. You see, they're supposed to come here. I was hoping they would come so we can go and see them and tell them to take the title off them. That's why they won't bring them. You see, it makes sense that they won't let the British ship come here, because we'll go and talk to them and tell them to arrest them. Yeah, they send all the ones that they do business with that protects their own private business. And so that's why I'm alerting the British High Commission here and warning them that they're dicing with this flag. And the consequences are they're going to lose everything if we get the British to go and get it, right? We can write anything what we like and seize the land here and get the British. The British has to do it, because they're our legal partners in business. They're still in a there's a contract. This flag is a contract receipt from a king. It's the only king flag in the world that can do that and go around the world anywhere with any ship, plane, or submarine or anything with this flag, and they've got to get out of the road. Right? And you can challenge anybody with this. In even the United States, you can go and put them out with this. That's what I'm doing now, right in their face. And people are watching there of what is happening to them. They're helpless because the Admiralty law is a state of emergency. That's what it is. It's a state emergency and blocks the whole place off, like what they did down Tuhoe, and put a cordon around it. Just what this flag, they used this flag for that. And they didn't get away with it because they had no authority to do that. They were using the Australian New South Wales state of emergency because they can't do it here because this flag stops them from doing that, right? That's why they got caught and lost the case. So yeah, we use the flag for that reason, for the state of emergency. So when we go into the Marae, in the Waitangi Marae, we put a state of emergency right on top of John Key and the rest of the world and the US. From all those ships coming here, I'm giving them notice now as a state of emergency with their flag. It's more or less got to get a standing order from Westminster. The same as what Mark Elia got a standing order, Clegg, or I think that name went. Yeah, Glenn Clegg or something like that. That's the name of the guy that made the standing orders. So I've got all those documents here of Marpilius, the whole works here. He wanted me to run it, you see. I said, no, I was doing aquafarms and seaweed in Japan. So I said, because there was too many other fellows with bright ideas, and it all collapsed. The fellow, Barrett was doing it, and the girl from Naughty Pro. I don't know where the incorporations have got to now, who's got it now. I've lost track of who's doing it. Just leave them like that. Just stick to the flag and what we do in Waitangi, because the incorporations are on the Queen side, right? In Titi Marae, that's where all those problems will always be in there, not on the other side. We kick them out on the other side. They can't talk on the other side. I'm going to make that quite clear with Kingi, that no one talks, and he can talk because he's a Queen Victoria Trust, where the money is. Okay, so that's his only reason, because he can talk for the King Edward and Queen Victoria over the top of anybody else with the flag and the money inside it. Even though he's a King Edward, that's why he's never supported this flag. He'll only talk around it, but not for it. That's the reason why he skips and keeps going out in the middle of not staying there and going right through. Is that reason. But I have him on my documents. It's fixed there now with his signature. I can use his signature electronically anytime I want to authorize all the things I do. All the documents I do are authenticated with his signature, because he's the last man on his feet and he's the oldest there. That's it. And the Heiheis are trying to take over, and because they come from Kororareka, it doesn't mean it's their name. If I told them right to their face in front of them, the whole lot of them will be surprised who they are. And Tracy, my daughter, says the Heihei is a chicken. That's what its name is, right? She says. Yeah. That's what the name is. Heihei is chicken. That the real surname, I can't find a name called chicken. Yeah, so they are taking, because that Kororareka area is being horribly mixed up, they haven't got a real chief in there that I can rely on with the right surname to fit the land, the natives. Yeah, that's right, yep. Yeah, that's right. That's yeah. Yep, you only needed one. You only needed one. You only needed you standing and put that flag up. You put it up twice on that hill and at Waitangi. That's sufficient enough to take control of the flag situation right through the world. I'm telling you, what you've done there is gone right through the world viral in what that flag is and what it means. And it's the blueprint for all the native countries in the world. They've taken the 1993 Land Act in Australia and New South Wales, and they've took it from there right around the world, from Australia. Yeah, that's right. So Yeah, that's right. Yeah, so yeah, that's right, Hauraki, yeah, because I went to, yeah, now, I was right through the middle of it in Whangarei. I used to go up to these office there, where they were playing music in there all the time, but I've got all his stuff here, the whole lot, I've got, because he gave me, No. No, I've never said anything about it because I was going down the Confederation track. And the Manukau history wiped the whole lot out. Because of that name, and it's in Cambridge University from 1820. And Cambridge here at Mangatauteri Hill, the park. What's that? Yeah, that's right. Hold on to it because that's the key. You're the key with that flag. Nobody else. I'm not picking anybody. That's why I've cut you out on those photos where the Tikaia was putting all those subtitles. I've got the subtitles under there. I've cut it out and put all the subtitles in. No, I've got the video there. I've videoed my own video. I've got my own video. I put it on there so you can see. I've cut out all those when the video went on. I cut it out with you there and the subtitle of what you were saying in Maori. It's in English. I've cut it out and stuck it right there. It's the copyright of Te Kaia, because they wanted an answer from the Navy of those two dates, 10th of March 1834 and the 20th of March 1834. Those two dates forms the basis of the titles here in this country and the world for that matter, from that Admiralty. It's the ship that brings the Admiralty private contract onto land. Yeah. You can forget about everything else anybody says. Because this overrides the whole lot with the flag. Those people flying the flag are mixing up their own stories in the flag. They're mixing it up on the Crown Queen side corporations and not the King's corporations. The King's bench is still in the court and they've locked it inside that Waitangi Marae and we're going to catch them right in the middle of it. They're making it public so then everybody knows why we're going there for, right? Yeah, on the 6th. We got the... The third, the fourth, fifth, and sixth to talk about it on Tijima, right? But when we go in there, nobody going to talk, only you fellas. You and the two native court judges. And Manahi's a real native court judge because he's been there the time of Mapiria and the incorporations, and he was in the courts all the time, right? He was at the hui at Whakatane, the Mataatua hui. He was there talking about his treaty claims. He I think his cousin is the president of the Waitangi Tribunal, Tangari. Manahi Tangari is the native court judge in the Waitangi Marae. I've got them all sort to go, all set to go. Yeah. so it's adding up because he got the right name, you got the right name, I got the right name, and the other one that's going to talk has got the right name, Kingy's got the right name for that commerce, and we can snap the whole lot off in Westminster. When I go to Westminster, it goes straight in. Yeah, so that's how it works, just to make it plain and simple for you, that the videos I put is saying it right to the point because I'm doing them at night when it's quiet and I can think. I'll have a look, I'll just make sure. It went to the one that I sent you stuff the last time. Hang on, I'm just trying to have a look. Hang on. Where is it? I'm just going into Chairman. Upoko. Treaty claims working. It's gone to. Where is it? Where is it? Hang on. I just tried to find the email. Chairman@aotearoahanui.com. Hey, is that the one? Yeah, that's the one that I've been sending stuff to. So you've got the videos I just made last night, just explaining that part of that video of you interview and me interview, because Takaya interview you and interview me. And so I'm just piecing all the story together, stitched it all up with the Manukau. Manukau is involved with the title in that as well. Of those lands, Referefa Manukau was up there, the son of Tira Waikato, was up at Russell. His grave, Mohi showed me his grave. I filmed him on a video, Mohi. We went walked up the stairs right to the top at Rafiti, I think it is, and up the hill. The grave site is right beside the gate, the first one you go, and he says it's there because he was the first one in that grave on that hill. That's the title there, the Manukau title, to that whole place over there. Okay? That's what Paulina is going on, because she's in that, she's got all that stuff as well. But no one will listen to you. See, when they're mad like that, they know too much. That's why they tell her shut up, but she knows all their titles. Huh? Yeah. Well, Pauline is the loud one, the Samoan one. Her husband is Ngapui, and she took me where their home is in Te Ngaere, where they signed those chiefs signed, put the flag together. She lives just there, right there, right? So she can talk about it, but I don't know if her husband should be there, but he certainly would have the right surname. But he's quiet, he won't say anything, right? Stays home, he don't go to the Hui's. Right, so he's got the key to that area, and mixed up with the Manukau family, the Referefa Manukau. That's why she keeps talking about me and talking about the Manukau all the time. That's when they light up. And that fellow Puru from Hunty, he talks about the Manukau as well. He was in the incorporations too. That fellow, but he don't listen to me much. He tried to take the whole thing himself and gets lost. He gets lost. Ponamu. Puru Ponamu, you see. Yeah. The trouble is that... Yeah, no, they're trying to be native sovereigns. But that won't get the money. The money's getting whipped off them from the land. While they're talking about sovereignty, the Pākehā is using the flag for their own use. They're using our flag for carving more money and land and water and everything. While you talk about sovereignty, and that's all, you won't make any money out of it. And they've still got to go and borrow money from John Key Bank. Yeah, so I'm using the power note to sting them all with, and that's all we had to do. Tāwhiao coming from the Waikato area as well, the Mangatatiri and all that area. But between you, you're just over the hill from me in Tauroa, down east coast, to where on the other side of us. And Yeah. So that we're hand in hand down that area in the Te Taira Whiti area, one of the four regions. And but soon Akora broke off with her because she didn't like what I was saying. And but that's okay. She can have a Maori government, but I'm not going to do anything with her anymore, because she's locked in the United Nations where all the trouble is. Yeah, now the thing is, yeah, so that's the trouble with her, is that she's still locked in the John Key system and going along with the United Nations where all the fraud is. That's all dirty money. That's the dirty money. That's what I said to her, it's dirty money. And when she was in the Marae, that's why she took off. She didn't come back in. She went to have an interview with that Maori television guy. When we were sitting there, and I said to her, look, you can't just put a title over this land on the other side, Waitangi Marae and this side, just like that, without telling anybody what you're doing. It's not right. And I said, no, Kingi's upset about that. And so that way she... She don't. No, that's right. You at least got your hands on the flag and put it up. That's the main thing. Now this time it goes up the right way, and we know what we're going to say, and we've got documents. I'm putting all the documents together to make sure it sticks to the seal of the king, and the new king that we've got that we're going to nominate into the throne to take over. the Ernest Augustus, that's King William's line, to this flag. So we've got to connect that up on the other end, and they're waiting for me to go there to do that job on that end. And it'll save the whole world, this flag, by doing that, because of the native title. It's the native title that you... Yeah, that's right. It will diffuse the use of the Admiralty bank mortgage loans and everything else inside the flag, if we just explain to everybody what it really is. And you'll be native, I'll be native, that's all that matters, a native and a flag and a reason why we're going to take it off them, right? Because that's what we're going to do. We have to do it. We have to tell them our intention to do it, then do it, right? And trap them, because they're not going to say we can't come, because that's New Zealand Day. They'll have to go in that marae, as they usually do, and then that's where we sit in there with them and tell them straight to their face. And the Navy. Yeah, that's the only way to do it, and say to them, well, this is our land, this is, you've had 182 years of lease occupation, you haven't bought it out, and that's the end. You can't buy it, it's not for sale. And here's the new lease agreement, or we're going to terminate the one you're on now and get the British to seize everything, all the titles. That's all you do, one shot, seize all the titles and reissue them through a British system with us. And that cuts out the Te Tiriti Whenua Act, because that's corrupted as well. We're just using the 1838 and 37 Westminster Acts of Parliament, scratch new, because it's easier to adopt them to the new system, right? That's to the rest of the world. I'm going under with this 8-point star. New World Order thing that we're part of in Britain as partners, right? So long as you know that, you know, it's easy for you to say it in Maori, from what I'm saying on those videos. And that's quicker. It's quicker to watch the video. Because when I went to court, the judge, my barrister said, oh, John wants to say something. And the judge said, no, there's no need. It's all on YouTube. And so I use YouTube all the time now for my statements, you see? Because the judge took it, the courts take it, you see, as evidence, all right? So that's the latest. I haven't spoken to Kingy yet. He's been a naughty boy, I'll catch up with him some stage, but there's time to do it. I'm just worrying about those warships coming, but I think the documents will do a lot for it, and go straight to the defence secretary of defence, and the letter will do it because everybody's reading it. All right? Everybody reads what I put, and then it goes to him. Yeah. Okay, Jim. We're going up on this. Well, the hui's on 10 o'clock on the 18th. Yeah, we can go up on the 18th. Okay, I can go up with you or whatever. Oh, okay. We'll go up on my car. Yeah. That's right. That we'll get a place up there, no trouble. Yeah, that's the best. That's the best. Yeah. That's fine. That's fine. Yeah. That's all right. That's all right. Okay. All right. Here we go, that's Jim. Jim Wikotu. He put this flag on both ships, both British ships. The one on Kororareka Hill on 10th of April 2016. He put this flag upside down up there. And then again on Waitangi Day. First of all, he put it up Waitangi Day on that ship there, upside down. This time, he's going to put it up the right way, for good, because we're terminating the lease on the land. The occupation lease is on the land, and get the British to reissue through us and the Moai Crown, King William IV, Federal State Commonwealth Government of the World, dual government in Britain. We'll fit that into Westminster from the chiefs here and Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court. And the two native court judges will be there trying John Key and his government and the Navy. Okay, the Navy has non-performance on their part of this flag of jurisdiction of Admiralty right through the world. They never showed, they never responded to the King's Seal letters that you see, that is the highest in the world authority right here. They failed to respond to King William's crown in the 8-point star of King William III, St. Patrick's Order. They failed to respond and come to the meeting to talk to us on the 28th of October 2016 and the 10th of April 2016 up to Kororareka on the hill. They failed. And they failed, John Key's government has failed to invite the British Navy here with the other Navy ships. You see, this is British. This is British, and the 8-point star you see on our flag is this. Right? Four of them in the four corners of the earth on the sea of blue, Admiralty. Court-martial law and financial martial law stuck on you, John Key, and Obama administration, Clinton Foundation, US federal state government, UN, NATO, IMF, City of London Corporation, Vatican City Corporation, private businesses, and Washington DC corporations, private businesses. Those three corporations are getting the 8-point star, King William the Fourth, King William the Third, jurisdiction of Admiralty, court martial law stuck right over you, bounty. Moai pound note. Moai King William Fourth pound note. And our King of Britain, UK, nominated King Ernest Augustus V, reigning monarch, sovereign of Britain, UK, Hanover, Aotea, New Zealand, Pacific Islands, Commonwealth, world title. Partnership with us. Okay? Private contract with the Moai native Indigenie chiefs here in Aotea, New Zealand. Alright, you get that? This is addition to Jim Wikotu as a unique native surname to this land. And my own Wanoa native to this land, Wa means the beginning and end of time and space, Noa, the law, L-O-R-E, the center of a marae, no tapu, means spiritually clean. There, that's what they mean, and paradise, in the middle. When you come through the gate, the manuhiri, visitors like John King, come through the gate. You have to lay down your weapons and your aggro and walk into the center and put down your mana right there. Okay, in front of the chiefs before you're invited in. Otherwise you get a whack on the head and drop right there. That's what Wanoa means. Okay, in Tahiti, Raiatea Island, Tapitapu Aotea Marae, to Easter Island, Rapa Nui, big sunshine midday, to Moko Nui, big face, at Te Pito, East Cape, on my Marangaro land blocks, Uetaha. Chief, Potikirua ki Waiapu boundary area. Cape Runaway, Potaka, Whakaangiangi, Raukamura Range, to Maraihara, to Tikitiki, Rangitukia, Waiapu River mouth, to Haha, Te Pito, right there. Te Pito is birth of Aotea New Zealand, to East Cape Island, Whanga, no Kena, Whanga o Kena Island, to Puruera, Te Araro, Hicks Bay, or Punaruku, Hicks Bay, Matakawa, Potaka, and Rangit, and Cape Runaway. Okay, there, that's the Potahirua Ki Waiapu boundary area. In the Te Tairawhiti boundary, four regions. Te Tairawhiti, where I come from, and Jim Wikotu, and Te Tai Tonga, South Island, Te Tai Te Tau Hauuru, New Plymouth, Whanganui area, and Te Tai Tokero, North of Auckland. Okay? Those are the four regions, four stars in the corners of the world, and four regions here. Government. We're going under a Moai crown, King William the Fourth, federal state. That's a federal state, Commonwealth, government of the world, in Westminster, in partnership here to the whole world. Inside Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court. That's what I'm explaining to Jim Wikotu, from Whakatohe, the Putiki, Mataatua, Waka, down there, and their chiefs, watching this video, your responsibility to uphold the history of the land and take it into Waitangi Marae. With Hokianga, Hokianga is hooked to Te Karere, to Korarareka. Those two go together on the history of British connections. My friend Moira Hoffman Russell, she's a Russell from Russell up there in Hokianga. She lived in Hokianga. British, my friend, partnership with me in this whole British Hapu Native Indigenie contract business. Okay, we're picking up on that with her. She's on Facebook, you can see her there. And her son, Kurt Hoffman, is a good friend of mine. They're both good friends of mine in Rotorua. So I'm working with her Russell family up in Russell, Korarareka, that's its name, was changed to Russell, and James Russell, I think it is, then, is the Navy village that I'm talking about. Captain Clendon, James Reedy Clendon, stood up and proclaimed on the dry land it belongs to the King of England, King William the Fourth. Okay, that's the title I'm going under to inform all the hapus here that that's the first title we need to worry about, and forget about all the rest, because that one will seize a whole lot. The Navy has to give the title back inside Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court. Jim, that's what we demand. We're demanding that. Sheriff is demanding it. The court, judge, Manahi, Tengari, and his cousin, I think it is, I'm going to get her name, is the president of the Waitangi Tribunal. Okay? They'll know what I'm talking about. You know, we're watching the GF, you know what I'm talking about. He's responsible to administer the court hearing with these documents are put in to that court to sever the 182 years from Korarareka title of the Navy. Okay, the Navy holds all the mortgage title liens right to the world. They're the ones that step off the ship and start proclaiming it belongs to the King, when in fact we're proclaiming that it belongs to the chiefs, not the King or the Queen. And it's our turn to sever the contract and write a new one up, or terminate their lease. They're only on the lease, they haven't got clear title. I'm in the real estate business before, and so they have not bought this land out, and they're talking to themselves in the mirror. The Maori iwi is not the legal owner, the real owner of these lands. It's the hapu Moai chiefs. Okay, the Moai is the memorial to the land. The government conveniently put the Moai in Dunedin with a head on his head, is the crown. They put that, hid that there, then they're operating their business with that memorial and this flag inside the King's Bench Court, Waitangi Marae. Okay? That's what they're doing. And the ship's outside with the crossbar, and the top they put the Union Jack flag, which is 200 miles operating in the sea. Not on dry land, on the sea, out there. In the economic zone, right? They're sitting out there with their flag in the middle of the ocean, and this flag flies on one side of the crossbar and the British flag on the other. Shows you the partnership. Jim Wikotu, that's the partnership. Now we're putting the flag from the crossbar, this flag, up to the top, and putting the Union Jack war flag for the veterans, war veterans, like King Toto, over here on the opposite side of the British to keep that contract going. Okay, take the Queen out, put the King up the top, throw the King, Queen out, sack her in Westminster from that court hearing. Sack her and put the new King, Ernest Augustus the Fifth, at the top, and his son, Prince Regent, Ernest Augustus, beside him to succeed to the King status, to keep the monarchy, British monarchy, going on the right track. Get rid of Hillary Clinton, Obama, and the Queen, the Rothschilds, the Pope, and all of them. Pope's using this 8-point star, and he's using Admiralty from the Queen, usurping the King's Admiralty 8-point star here. It's not there for nothing. It's here, and they use the 8-point star you'll see here on Ernest Augustus. King Ernest Augustus V is wearing the 8-point star here. He's the real one. The Queen is wearing it. Where the hell did she get it from? And Prince Charles is wearing it. Everybody that's not the right bloodline, down the male line, they're down the female line, which sells land, the king doesn't do that. Okay? The king takes everything back, gives back to the people, and then resumes his role as a proper king, not a queen. No more queen. Out. Sack her, hang her, and everything this flag does. This flag will hang her. The Hanging Chains Act, 1834, applies. We have the legal right to use the 1830-1837 acts of William, King William IV, Westminster Parliament, in this contract, locked at 1835-1834. Okay? The 1835 Declaration of Independence was done in the Titi Marae, and the 1834 was done in the Waitangi Marae. You see the difference in the two? I'm separating the two. And the people on this side, with all the corporations and all the Crown corporations, businesses here, can't talk on the outside. Only the British and the chiefs with the right surnames, not the bodgy surnames. I'm saying once again, Ohepa, your name is Epping, E-P-P-I-N-G. That's why you go to New South Wales for your holiday, because you're going back to Epping, the village in New South Wales, Sydney. That's yours. Okay, our video is running short now. It's running out. It's just over an hour. It's starting to beep, but I'll carry on going until it stops, because that's sufficient enough for this segment of the video to Jim Wikotu, Chief of Whakatohea. And I just want to say to the USS Samson ship visiting Auckland, take heed of this warning, that it is a highly offensive crime act to enforce your TPPA and your martial law here in front of this flag of Admiralty jurisdiction straight to Westminster and the British High Court of Admiralty in London. This is a complaint already lodging inside this video to the public and international arena of people watching, that the consequences of your ignorance is going to cost you the pound note, trillion pound note on your heads as bounty on any piracy act on this land in Aotea, New Zealand, while it is still in the ownership of the chiefs of the tribes here and their hapus and the natives right through the world under this blueprint of King William IV's Admiralty, not Vice Admiral. I'm talking Admiralty, not Commander in Chief. I'm talking Chief Commander, Kingi Tauroa. At this stage, I've got him right there, Queen Victoria Trust, Chief Kingi Tauroa. Chief Commander. I'm saying that. His name is right there. It's not going to change. Nothing's going to, nothing anybody says of Waitangi and Titi Marae is going to change that. It's too late. You haven't caught up with this lot, with the Manukau land title, superseding all the titles here, seats. Okay, that's what this is all about, is dominance of the whole earth planet on the four corners of the earth with this flag that you see with the four stars in the corners of the globe. So that's what I'm really saying. You can see the eight stars there, 8 points in the blue middle of the ocean. That just tells you that it's here, our authority to use as his partner, and Westminster government is responsible to recover all debts and property belonging to the King's Bench Court. I write on the pound note the amount you have to pay, John Key. You have to pay Obama. You have to pay Clinton. You have to pay Rothschilds, Soros, the Pope, the Queen, IMF, the United Nations, NATO, and Bilbo, Illuminati, Queen's Crown Corporation agents, Crown agents, you'll all have to pay. Police, on the police side, you've already been issued warning of £1 trillion on your head each. This is just qualifying that again on this video update that we're sticking to the pound note that you see online. That's real. That's a levy debtors instrument against fraud and corruption on our land and anywhere in the world on native land. Okay, for all the indigenous people of the world, this is your saviour, the King's Bench Court. In Waitangi, the highest court of jurisdiction of Admiralty in the world. The only one with a British ship right beside the courthouse. In the world. With the British flag flying, this flag, and the flag of the nation. Okay, well, all we're going to do is put this one up the top and put the other one on the cross rung, and that's the end of that. There's not going to be no other flag on this land, John Key. You can forget about your fern football flag. And you got beaten by Ireland anyway. Thank goodness for that. Ireland is going back to Britain. I've seen it. They want to go back in Britain and forget the EU Parliament and dump it. Well, dump it. Okay? And dump Clinton and Obama and the FBI, the whole lot. Dump the leader, James Comey. Okay? So a few people need dumping there. Loretta Lynch, Department of Justice, dump her. Dump a few people, dump John Key, and dump everybody that's in the road of Brexit in Britain. Theresa May, quite happy so far, and Nigel Farage, quite happy so far with those two, to stay there and wait for us, to bring their flag, to put it up in Westminster, and beside the Williams Memorial in Plymouth, in Devon, Port. William Yard, Navy Yard, biggest in the world at that time. He was 50 years in the Navy and set up New York before he became king in the stock exchange. This is all that commerce, banking, stock exchange, everything is wrapped up in this flag as commerce, king of the sea, king of the royal revenue in the King's Bench Court. Okay, and mounts to this seal. This 8-point star, the New World Order, this way, not the Pope's New World Order. This is the New World Order inside Westminster. It's going back together. Humpty Dumpty put London back together again. London's bridge is burning, and we're coming to put out the fire. Okay, that's all I want to say. Matt Taylor, there. He's the leader of the Moai King William Party in London, and also the leader of the secretary of the Moai Powerhouse Group Limited Company, registered in the Company's House in London. Okay, that's all I want to say for now. And my friend Jamie Anna Marie Patrick Stewart in Whakatane. Just hold fire there until we get this sorted out at Waitangi. So you've got plenty of time to get organised. And I'm hoping that you'll come to Britain and to Scotland, Ireland. And Netherlands, Denmark, to sort out the tidal turbines with my friends, good friends, the Littler Gordons in Aberdeenshire, Scotland, up from Balmoral Castle, only about 1 hour from Balmoral Castle, and Glasgow, where the Manukau land titles are. The Manukau land company titles are in Glasgow, just up the road there. That's why I want to go there and check the titles. You'll find they're correct. And what I'm saying with the Manukau Land Company here and all the titles right through this country is the Manukau Land Company titles. Okay, so that's all I'm going to say. Have a nice day today, and we'll see you again soon. Bye for now.